caliente, the cat is getting warmer. Oh, I wish it wasn't, but it is.
Didn't it just get warm?
I've got the feet cut up.
Oh my gosh.
What's your
thought? Oh, it's heavy. Oh my goodness.
I have it right on me, so I'm doing just fine right now.
Of course. I know. I'd like that too.
Please check to make sure your seatbelt is securely fastened.
Thank you. A month ago, it was not that. Now the temperatures can go up and down.
Yes, he says the weather here is bipolar.
Yeah.
Because he's from California, he moved over here to go to school and then he was staying.
Oh, okay.
I told him if he met a girl out here, that was going to be bad, but that's what I'm
going
to do. See, now we have to come all the way out here to see him.
Yep.
But he can come next time.
Sure.
Visit us.
There you go. Yeah, I love those little compound cats. Look at my head.
Yeah.
Because of the heat, Dolly, I couldn't do it no more. Absolutely, honey. Absolutely.
I don't think I can do that. I wear my hair up, too. And my hair thinned out a lot because of my thyroid.
It was too thick. It was too much. My husband was like, please don't do it.
But at least you didn't cut it off. So all your hair was there.
I would like to, though, Dolly.
See, but they like us.
He doesn't want me to, though. I know. That's what he said. Please don't do that.
My sister had long hair down to here, and she cut it up to here, and I don't like it.
Yeah.
She had, our faces need more hair.
Yeah, I agree. Because once you cut it, you miss it.
Yeah,
that was
and
bad.
It will take forever to grow back, though.
Yeah.
You have to go through that ugly stage.
I know.
Yeah.
That's why I won't shave over here.
Yeah.
Because if you shave over here, you're going to go through the little craziness over here. You know what I mean? Like, no.
Yeah.
It's just too much. I kind of have like a shave hair thing, kind of needle.
Nobody knows.
Exactly.
Except for you, if you go like this.
Yeah.
And then you use less shampoo.
It's less time to dry my hair. Before it was a long time, now.
Yeah.
Look at that. Much better. Less hassle. Less hassle.
Less, like when I straighten my hair.
Oh, I straighten my hair too. I do keratina. The keratin. I do too. Mine is frizzy. So I do the keratin treatment.
Oh, how long does that last?
7 months, honey. Months, yes. It's
and
worth
you,
it.
How often do you wash it?
Every 3 days.
Oh my God, I gotta look that up.
Now, when you do the keratin treatment, though, you cannot wet your hair for 3 to 4 days. After that,
you're fine. I better do that on a weekend.
Yeah. But then after that, it's so much easier to comb, to style, to dry. So much easier.
Because our frizzy hair, it's dry and it's...
Exactly.
Yeah.
If the keratin is lovely, then you know what else I take? Biotin.
Yeah, that is one thing I can't take.
Oh,
my
you
thyroid.
Can?
Yeah.
How about vitamin E?
Yeah, I can take that.
I take vitamin E. Lovely for
my
nails, for my hair. Oh yes, vitamin E is a plus plus plus.
She had breast cancer, so she lost all
her
hair. So she took the vitamin. She takes it. And she had really pretty nails.
Sure.
All her hair didn't come back.
Absolutely.
Might not work tomorrow. We're doing Thanksgiving tomorrow.
From all of us,
well, good for you.
Yeah, it was going to be too much for you guys. Luckily, you're supposed to be here at 6
o'clock.
We're only a half an hour late.
Really?
Well, no, compared to what time you were supposed to be here. We're supposed to be here at 6:30.
Yeah, that's not bad.
Well, okay.
So we're only a half an hour.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
Yeah,
worked out. Fly standby like we do? We fly standby.
No.
My husband used to be an aircraft mechanic for the airline, United. So we fly standby.
Oh, that's nice. No, we
don't
do that.
Oh, okay.
We work at a hospital, so.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
My husband used to work at the VA.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So he worked on airplanes,
yes,
too?
Yes, he did.
Huh?
Aircraft mechanic.
Oh, that's awesome.
But not at United, it was in Continental days, back when United was Continental.
I remember Continental.
Yeah.
Yes.
Same airline though, it's just different.
Yeah. So they let you, that's why you guys are right next to each other. I was going to ask,
it's standby, yes.
Yeah, you got to take what you get.
Right, exactly. Yeah. So this morning we had first class.
Oh,
and
so
then
they'll give you that too?
Sure. If there's a space, they'll fit us in.
So you got to eat the food.
Absolutely.
They had first class
earlier.
That's good. And they're on standby. And then they gotta eat. We gotta watch everyone. We're like, can I at least buy what they're eating, please?
Is that right?
Because we were hungry. We're like,
I know.
And they gave us some nasty little crackers.
Crackers, yeah.
Yeah, wasn't even like, I'd rather have peanuts.
I know. Oh, remember that? Remember when they used to do honey
Southwest
roasted peanuts?
It. Southwest does it.
Do they?
Yes.
Oh my God. You know what? We could bring our own.
Well, I think it's because the nut. People have all those nut allergies.
Oh.
That's why they stopped doing that.
Oh, actually, United does pretzels.
Yeah, I know. And we didn't get any pretzels.
But I'm into pretzels and peanuts.
I did bring my own pretzels, and they didn't give some pretzels on the way for a 5.5 hour flight.
No, we didn't.
It's horrible.
Oh,
we didn't get any. We got crackers, one thing
and
crackers.
Well, pretty soon there's going to be dehydrated beef jerky served on United Airlines.
Oh, good.
So.
I brought my beef jerky.
Oh, there you go.
I was ready. I brought pretzels and beef jerky.
All right. Welcome home, everyone. Well, you guys have a beautiful, safe, lovely Thanksgiving and a wonderful family. Yes, thank you. Family time. There's Bubby. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, Dolly. It didn't hit you, did it? Oh, thank God. Thank God. My God.